Okay, it's time to discuss case number 42. A 30-year-old man presents to the emergency department complaining of chills, myalgia, which is muscle pain, and extreme throbbing pain in his right shin. He fractured his tibia 3 weeks ago and required external fixation. His temperature is 40 degrees centigrade or 100 degrees Fahrenheit. Blood pressure is 30 degrees over 80. And his heart rate is 80 per minute. Physical examination reveals that his right leg is red, tender, warm, and swollen over the anterior tibia just inferior to the knee. X-ray of the extremity demonstrates periosteal elevation and changes consistent with soft tissue swelling adjacent to the tibia. The patient is admitted and blood and bone biopsy cultures are pending. This picture I have osteomyelitis. You can see we're looking at the foot. I saw a very interesting presentation of osteomyelitis on YouTube, so that's why I have that picture, because it reminds me of what I just watched. Anyway, what is the most likely diagnosis? Osteomyelitis. Staphylococcus aureus is responsible for approximately 90% of pyogenic osteomyelitis cases. Staph aureus expresses receptors for the bone matrix, thus allowing it to adhere to bone and produce a focus of infection. Many affected adults have a history of compound fracture or surgery. What patient populations are susceptible to this condition? Osteomyelitis can be a sequela of trauma, as is the case in this patient, but is also found in intravenous drug users, and they get a direct injection of bacteria. And patients with diabetes who have poorly controlled blood glucose. Bacteremic patients, typically children, may develop osteomyelitis as a consequence of hematogenous spread. How does a subperiosteal abscess lead to accelerated bone necrosis? A subperiosteal abscess separates the bone from its blood supply in the periosteum, leading to ischemic injury and necrosis. A history of sickle cell disease would increase this patient's risk of infection from which pathogen? Patients with sickle cell disease have an increased risk of developing salmonella osteomyelitis because of the reduced immune clearance of this pathogen. What are the typical imaging findings? Periosteal elevation is often found on plain film radiography. This finding, however, can lag up to 2 weeks behind the onset of infection. MRI sensitive but not specific, as it cannot distinguish osteomyelitis from other causes of marrow edema, such as normal post-surgical changes. Negative MRI findings essentially exclude osteomyelitis.